Okay, so something that people may or may not know about me is that I actually love a good indie movie every now and then. I'm pretty sure the last two movies I reviewed on this channel, minus My Little Pony, that one, I don't think so, but are indie movies. And you know what? I actually like those. Some of my other favorites, God, I'm gotta think. I saw Rachel Getting Married. Rachel Getting Married was good. I heard that Whiplash is an indie movie. I didn't know that. And then, of course, my favorite, Little Miss Sunshine. I can never get enough of Little Miss Sunshine. I'm pretty sure there's more, I just can't think of them right now. But what I've never seen is a indie movie musical that's oddly specific. But they're never musicals. Until I came across this movie called Song One. And from the looks of it, it doesn't really look like a musical. But, you're listening to Future Me, so I've already seen this movie. Yeah, there's a lot of songs. So, I would definitely call it a musical, even though it's not your standard musical. And it is interesting to say the least. So, we will just get into this. I will just like to say that the audio in this video, not the voiceover audio, but the actual clips are going to be a bit weird because I didn't realize that as I was recording the clips, my microphone was on. This was my first time recording from my computer, so probably not going to do that again. I did it with my phone for the Wild Target video, so I apologize for that, but let's just get into this. The premise of this film is pretty simple. Basically, we have the main character, I think her name's Franny, played by Anne Hathaway, and her brother gets into a coma, and her brother is like an aspiring singer. He really likes this one guy, and she meets this one guy. It's simple, and I'll explain it along the way, of course. And so this film actually opens up with Franny's brother singing a song, and oh my God, it is so good. He is such a good singer. I don't know why, but for some reason I expected the singing to just be kind of mediocre, because I feel like with a movie that's not very well known, you just expect the singing to not be that great. But all of the singing in this movie is incredible. I mean, it is so good that other than the two main characters, because they're famous, people pretty much know that they can sing. I'm going to include every single musical number that happens in this movie. You can complain all you want. I am going to include it because, oh my God, these people need more credit. Anyways, shortly after this, the brother gets hit by a car because he had his headphones in and I guess didn't hear the car coming, which, by the way, kids, when you're crossing the street, try not to have headphones in. And if you do, I've been guilty of that before, make sure that your volume is low enough to where you can hear if a car is trying to honk at you, especially if you're in a busy city, you know, stay safe out there. We are then introduced to Anne Hathaway's character, Franny, who is in this tent watching these women get henna tattoos and they're just kind of dancing around, singing. It's sort of implied in this scene that she's, you know, like, traveling. But it's later revealed that she travels. I think they mentioned she's, like, doing college or something. Like, this is for college. And she's traveling and taking pictures and all that. And then she hears that her brother has gone into an accident, so she has to go back home.
Your brother was in an accident. He's in the hospital. You need to come home.
We are then introduced to Franny and her brother Henry's mother, played by Mary. I can't pronounce the last name. She was the mom in Elf. She was in The Proposal, Back to the Future Part 3. I totally don't have her information right in front of me.
Cut off all your hair.
Yeah, Mom, like you totally missed it. You were probably too busy filming The Help to notice, but I chopped it all off during Les Mis, you know? I mean, Fantine, you know, her hair is supposed to be cut off because she's, like, selling it, and so I just had them cut off my real hair, and, you know, here we are. Oh, and I sang in that movie and everything, and, you know, I got an Oscar, so we're Oscar buddies now.
With endless wonder, he took my childhood!
Okay, jokes aside, that's not the point of this scene. The point is to basically show, you know, that Henry, he wants to be a singer. He's like aspiring to be a singer, like a famous singer. And Franny has never really been home. She's, you know, been too busy traveling, taking pictures of women getting henna tattoos in tents. So now that Franny is back home, she is looking in her brother's room and sees that she's a big fan of this artist called James Forrester. Do not forget his name. He is coming back big time. And she finds this musical recording that her brother recorded and is like, oh my god, he is actually amazing. Why are the cuts in this movie so weird? Oh my god! They should have just made this movie Sunshine Cleaning, okay? Because that movie said the most out-of-pocket things, but they knew that they were being ridiculous.
You are going fast!
No, I'm not! How can I be going faster? I'm walking backward. I have the hard job.
Yeah, guys, Franny's just really upset, you know? Like, her brother's injured in a coma. We don't know if he's gonna wake up. And she's just continuing to listen to his music, which, by the way, the music actually does go a little bit deeper than would initially seem, so just wait. We find out when Franny's looking through his diary that he is not only a freaking amazing artist, but that he has tickets to go see James Forrester's concert. And so Franny just decides to go to the concert because, you know, her brother can't. So Franny goes to, you know, this amazing concert with this amazing singer in what looks like to be a high school gymnasium. Look, I'm not trying to judge this movie too hard. I know it's an indie movie, so, you know, it was an independent project. It probably had limited stuff. The budget was $6 million. But if this were the only time that the set looked like this, I would have given it a pass, obviously. But it looks like this even when interview scenes and music videos you're about to see. But you know what? The guy's a good singer, so who cares?
Waiting for the dawn.
Franny goes up to what was his name, Forrester, right? That's his last name. I forget his first name, but she gives him a record that, you know, her brother wrote. And before we get into the aftermath of this event, let's get into our first musical performance by a non-known person. And not soon after that, we have another amazing musical number, this time with a band. So then Franny goes to visit her brother in the hospital, where she has what I think, I'm assuming, is his favorite brand of pancakes, and then she, like, brings it up to him to smell. And this scene is honestly one of the factors that made me not want to do this video, because, you know, I've never experienced a family member in a coma, and I've never known anyone who has, and I can't imagine, you know, what the fictional characters who I honestly barely know and know the relationship with are going through. But, you know, it's a sensitive topic, and I'm trying to be as, you know, like, open-minded to it as possible.
Hey.
I was
just in the area and thought, maybe I'd just, you know, stop by. Didn't know if you liked sugar.
So keep in mind that this movie is set in New York, which I used to live near, and I've been to a couple of times, and this can't be the only hospital, right? I mean, from what I remember, Franny did not give the information of the hospital that her brother was staying at to this guy, and if she did, that's kind of terrifying. Don't do that, guys. Please don't. That is a terrible idea.
Thank you so much for coming. And for the tea.
Oh.
Wait, that was tea? So why was it in, like, a cappuccino cup, and why was he asking for sugar? Do people put sugar in the tea? Hang on. Well, it is considered normal to add sugar with tea in places like the US and UK. It is virtually unheard of in Japan. Okay, well, there's our answer. So then Franny asks this random famous man out for dinner.
What?
The place.
Barry and 11th, North 11th in Williamsburg.
Oh, now you're asking for a location. Okay, we just kind of assumed, you know, that you would know where Franny was going, considering that, you know, you found her so easily last time.
Thank you. What about keyboards?
Yeah, we just got in a vintage 59 Rigoletto.
Can I see it?
So Franny and James go on this, I was about to say date, dinner, and Franny confesses that she never really was supportive of her brother's music. Like, her brother would send her things, but she would never open them, which is just the beginning of my hate for Franny.
I didn't open a single one.
I'm sorry.
It's all right. I can't even imagine.
You're James Forrester, right?
Yeah.
Will you sign my iPod?
Sure.
Okay, four things. First of all, iPod. Second of all, why were they approaching them like that? Their smiles were kind of freaking me out. I mean, to be fair, thank God they weren't, you know, like going up and going crazy. They were being respectful. Third, I'm very surprised this is the first fan interaction we have. Even though this guy's concerts are like $30, his music sure isn't, you know? And fourth of all, oh my God, is that Taylor Swift? Well, hey, we got more music performances. And so after those two amazing performances, James and Franny flirt or talk, I guess. I don't know what the scene is, honestly.
You know, the best thing about playing, you know when you have a feeling and you don't want to fade away, but you don't really know how to keep it. Well, that feeling comes back when I play, like I can keep it.
Listen to us, into a song. Here's a note. Rhymes with roses.
So remember earlier when Franny went into the music store, so she was looking for a keyboard, you know, and so the point of that was that she wanted to play the keyboard for her brother in the hospital room, which to me it doesn't make any sense, because why doesn't she just bring James along? Because, you know, James is his favorite singer, so it just makes sense. And, you know, that guy just kind of strut in without any problem last time, so. But I mean, who needs James? Because Franny's performance on the keyboard is the best in this movie. Oh my God, and I absolutely do not remember the point of the scene. I just remember thinking it was ridiculous. So Franny's watching an interview with James Forrester, and it just straight up says James Forrester interview, and it looks like it was filmed in his house. Which, you know, sometimes interviews do look like that, but after the concert and also the clip of the music video, the budget was $6 million. I mean, so I think it was mentioned that it's Henry's half-birthday, so Franny's mother, remember her, she decided to make some cupcakes.
It's June 4th.
Damn it!
God!
Get the cupcakes out of the oven!
God.
So they go to the hospital to, you know, celebrate the brother's half birthday. James is there for some reason, and it's revealed that not only was Franny not supportive of her brother's music career, but her mother was, and her mother didn't really like how Franny, like, left them for 6 months and, you know, was not supportive.
You can't tell me that you thought that dropping out of college was a good idea.
Franny.
He did not want to go back. What was I supposed to do? You never would have let me do that.
You never would have wanted to have done that. Ever. And speaking of you, you basically dropped off the grid for 6 months. For 6 months, we didn't hear anything from you. And that, oh, is that okay?
No, I called you.
Yeah, Franny, why didn't you support your brother while you were in random people's tents and riding camels and taking pictures? Okay, but in all seriousness, I find this concept to be so weird. Maybe it's because I'm an older sister or something, but why would you not support your sibling, especially if your parents are? I mean, it's just, you're not their parent. I don't understand. I hate Franny. I hate Franny. We have another musical number. Franny goes to pay a random visit to James, and you know what, guys? I feel like their conversations are getting so much better.
Decided to.
You want a star fruit?
No, thank you.
Alright, y'all, welcome back to English 2. Now, I want y'all to write me a sentence or two or three about the significance of the star fruit in song 1. Just comment down below and I'll give you your grade. Yeah! Jesus Christ, I can't show that. Okay, well, I mean, it's official. They're together now, so you know what? Maybe the interactions will be less awkward.
This is my favorite song in the world.
I'm ready. This is your favorite song?
Okay, oh, not that one. No, it's a guilty pleasure.
Can we just get back to the brother that's in a coma? I mean, seriously, I feel like I know nothing about him and Franny and their relationship, even though they've told us in fragments. Okay, thank God. So it's not the brother, but it's another musical number. I let that one play out for a while because if I'm seeing this correctly, that is our last musical number by an ensemble. And oh my god, this next clip has the most beautiful song ever sung about the Empire State Building. So after that lovely duet, the two are now in their two-day relationship to the point where they are now meeting parents. To be fair, he has met Franny's mom before, but you know, it's official now, so you know, they just gotta, you know. Sounds just how I remember it. All jokes aside though, Anne Hathaway really is a good singer. I no hate to her voice whatsoever. And I actually, to this movie's credit, I actually do like how she wasn't a good singer in this movie because it's like, you know, it's not Anne Hathaway, it's Franny, and Franny is not a singer. But, you know, Anne Hathaway, she's a great singer. I love her voice. She's amazing. Oh my god, finally there's a moment with Franny when she's with Henry and all alone. Oh my god, guys, this is huge. This is huge. Maybe I could actually feel some chemistry between them, you know, maybe actually feel sad about what's happening. This scene is huge. Oh, come on! The clip that was rudely panned to was James at the wedding that he was performing at, and James actually comes back to the hospital and he actually performs for Henry, guys. Based on what I could find on Google, this part is actually pretty accurate to comas. Sometimes patients can periodically open their eyes. So I will ask my doctor mother about this just to be sure, but from what it's looking like, this seems pretty accurate. So Henry is starting to wake up, you know, but he's not at that full stage yet. But you know what did get him there? Franny's amazing keyboard playing. Hey, Henry, it's me, your unsupportive sister.
Excuse me?
Yes, dear.
Have you seen a guy with a guitar case?
Sorry, I haven't.
Of course, he left. I understand, you know, the movie did mention that he had a tour, so obviously he's probably going to go catch the tour. So I'm going to give him the benefit of doubt and saying that, oh, he just couldn't stay, and who knew if the brother would even wake up. He didn't know. But he could have left a message or something. I don't know. I mean, they were in a week-long relationship where they already met the parents. I mean, he could do something, especially because the whole point of them even meeting is for the brother. Oh my god, this makes me mad. So Franny goes to his concert, which, by the way, was just a train ride away. And I actually do want to emphasize in this part the amazing violin, I think it's violin, playing that's going on right here. I don't know if it's the actual actor playing or not, but regardless, it's really good. So Franny tries to buy tickets for his concert, but it's completely sold out, so she resorts to watching him on the screen that's just conveniently there, which he is performing a song that he says is dedicated to her. So after the concert, James goes to his car and sees a recording of the Empire State Building, a song that they recorded, which I didn't know that was videotaped or recorded or anything, but they listen to it. He listens to it in the car, Franny listens to it on the train.
You don't wanna go up high, don't wanna touch the sky, cause you're afraid
of heights.
And that's the end of the movie. So this movie, I mentioned this before, I was very hesitant about doing it. When I asked my sister if I should, she's just like, it's kind of serious, I don't know if you want to or not. And I was like, okay, maybe I won't. And as I was watching it, I was like, I'm not really feeling the emotion that I think they want me to. And there's just ridiculous scenes. And the chemistry between the characters, like, I understand that it was supposed to be awkward, but I've seen movies before where two characters, they have awkward chemistry, if that makes any sense, but it's not like this. And I feel like the brother in a coma was just kind of a side story. It's like, oh, look at this beautiful love story, by the way, the brother's in a coma, you know. And if the movie focused more on the brother and his relationship with Franny and like the actual, you know, trauma of having a family member in a coma, I would not do this video. Even if all the other silly awkwardness was in there, I would not do this video. But just because it seemed like a side story and I just didn't feel anything, that's really why, and why I'm making fun of this video, this movie. I do want to talk about some positives in this movie because, you know, it was a smaller budget, and the director, I actually didn't know this, but the director, this is their debut film. And I have to say, for a debut film, it is not bad whatsoever. And for a $6 million budget, you know, it's not. It could be a lot worse. And the musical numbers are incredible, you know? I have no hate to any of the singers, even the leads, you know, they're incredible. The talent is amazing in this movie. Rotten Tomatoes says, song one has plenty of earnest charm, but that isn't enough to overcome its slight familiar story. I actually disagree. I don't think the story was familiar. I just think it played it too safe. Like, you have a great story going on. It just, they didn't really do anything with it, which I don't like hating on a movie because it plays it safe. That to me just seems, I don't know, it just doesn't seem right. Because you could still have a good movie that has a simple plot and all, but I just feel like with this movie didn't achieve what it was trying to, if that makes sense. But, you know, love the cast, love the musical numbers. The director did a fantastic job considering the budget and everything. And yeah, please let me know what you think of this movie. Let me know if I'm being too harsh or if I'm making any jokes that seem insensitive, because I understand that when I'm trying to be funny, it can come off that way. Just know I'm not trying to be insensitive whatsoever. I'm just trying to make jokes and be funny. Everything is satire, but please let me know and how I can improve. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Let me know what movie I should do next.